nothing but this p 0 0 p minus 4 by p power half.
Well, I think I forgot that I can go back and see. So what was done yesterday, we gave this theorem of Conan for uniform theory. This is take n odd square free to take the old class to be the duplication of forms coming from the lower levels. I think strictly less than n levels, you take it 4 times d, where d strictly less than n. Take all the forms in the plus space, then apply the u operator, u r square. So this, after applying, they all belong to level 4. So you take all of them, put together and call it as old form, and then take the orthogonal complement with respect to the Petersen scalar product and call the orthogonal complement as the new form space. Okay, that is the way it is defined. Therefore, one has the whole space decomposed as the new as well as old as an orthogonal direction. And then the first theorem, he proved that this UP square and WP preserves space of the new forms. That is the main thing, because we need to find a basis for HK operators with respect to all HK operators, including the prime dividing level. So for that, we need this particular result. Moreover, he proves that UP square is minus P4K minus 1 WP. The WP is a Hermitian involution that is already seen. So after proving this, theorem 2 is that give the decomposition of the whole space into the direct sum of new form spaces. So the new and old are orthogonal complement. The old class is an ordinary direct sum. So one has this property that plus new 4n has an orthogonal basis of Hecke eigenform with respect to all Hecke operators, including the primes dividing the level. And in fact, for prime dividing the level, eigenvalues are plus minus p power k minus 1. If f is a new form, one can find a normalized new form of level n in the integral weight case, such that this capital F has the same eigenvalues as f, the lambda p's are same, and this f and f are related through the modified Shimura-Lifting, which is given in terms of maps depending on the fundamental discriminants d rather than square 3 p, because the Fourier coefficients survive only they are the minus 1 4 k n is a square modulo 4. Therefore, you cannot take any square free, so therefore you need to modify it for fundamental discriminants. So he gets this particular identity, and then this AF of mod d comes out in the, and then once you expand the Dirichlet series identity into Fourier expansion, this is exactly the mapping of the Shimura-Conan map. So he proves that this it preserves the space of new forms, and also he defines the plus minus eigenspace of the involution small wp for p dividing the level. So if I intersect this plus eigenspace with the new form, it is isomorphic to, it also maps to the corresponding plus eigenspace with respect to the w operator p and then their new form. And the Hecke operators commute in the, this map commutes with the Hecke operators, and also one finds the linear combination of these maps which are nice. Okay, so this is the statement. And then first we showed that the wp preserves the space of old forms. You take n square 3, you take f in the level 4 n by p for p dividing n. After, if you compute the wp, you get this Fourier expansion, and one can find that f bar wp has this particular expansion. So after some kind of calculation, so this substitute here in this one, so what we get finally is that f bar wp is sum plus minus this minus 1 4k n by p symbol af n plus p 4k af of n by p square. This particular two terms are nothing but part two, no, two terms of the Hecke operator for tp square in the case of half integral weight, except for the np square term which is missing. Therefore, you subtract the np square from this, then I get the tp square minus f bar up square. The way it is old form is defined, if f is in the level n by p, and this particular f bar up square belongs to the old class. That is the meaning. If f is in level 4 n by p, p will not divide n by p. Therefore, tp square preserves the space. Therefore, this belongs to, in fact, this belongs to, instead of old, I can say that gamma 0 4 n by p, because p does not divide and f belongs to 4 n by p, and this belongs to gamma 0 4 n, because it is, this belongs to 4 n by p, and up square if I apply, it will come back to 4 n. So these are all old class. One is level 4 n by p and 4 n by p duplication. Therefore, WP preserves the space of old forms. On the new form space, so this is what we have to prove now. UP squared is minus P4K minus 1 WP. So that's what we prove. Today we will start this. So for that, you take the the trace operator from level n to level n by p.
So
we start with that. What did I start with? So because this question was asked last time, so on, that's what we have. So take the trace operator sk plus half plus 4n by p, sorry, 4n to 4n by p. 4n to sk plus half plus 4n by p. So one can be the trace operator. So he computes explicitly. So if f belongs to uniform space, if I apply the trace, it will map to the old class. Now old class is orthogonal to the new class. Therefore, this implies f bar trace equal to zero. Okay, that's what, if f belongs to uniform space, f bar trace is zero. So what is he computes the trace explicitly. It is given in the terms of f bar trace 4n. This snap is given like this. This is in terms of action. This is mu modulo p f bar. The standard calculation one can do that 4n by p 1 star 1 mu 0 1 star. Okay, this is the trace operator when you do the usual. So the right hand side matrix product, so this is nothing but this p 0 0 p minus 4 by p power half into wp. The wp is the, okay, the w operator for the prime p in the case of half integral weight, which is defined earlier. So 1 mu a 0 p p power 1 by 4. So this matrix product, if you take it, one can show that this is equal to this. Therefore, replacing this, this implies f bar trace is f plus minus 4 by p power minus k minus half coming from this part. And we have p power will be coming, p power k minus 2 by 3 by 4 into f bar wp. And this is nothing but up. And also one can check that. So since a is a fixed number as mu modulo p, and a is relatively prime to p, therefore mu a also varies modulo p. Therefore, this is the usual take care operator up. That's why this part p power comes out to take care of that. Okay, so now f bar trace is zero implies this, for since f belongs to new form, new form space, don't say new form, this is a new form space, implies f bar trace is zero. Therefore, this implies f bar wp up is minus of minus 4 by p power minus k minus half p power k by 2 minus 3 by 4 f. Okay, now next we want to, another property is that this upwp is an isomorphism of the new form space. So upwp is an isomorphism. In fact, he again proves that it's an isomorphism on the space of new forms. Okay, so therefore I can replace f by f bar upwp, still it is a new form. Therefore, replacing f by f bar upwp, and noticing the wp square is some minus 4 by p symbol for half, that was already done before. So it's not exactly identity, it is some plus minus 1. Plus minus I square is plus, yeah, square is plus minus 1. So wp, if I do that, if I f bar up, wp square up will be there. That constant is exactly minus 4 by p power k plus half. This is the wp square value. So f bar up square. So what you do here, I have up wp on the left, I am applying. There is already one sitting on wp there, up there. So this wp square is minus 4 by p, so that comes out. Then up into up is up square, so that is the computation on the left, which is equal to, we have minus of minus 4 by p power minus k minus half p power k by 2 minus 3 by 4 f bar up WP. Okay. And then UPW, the small WP is in terms of UPWP times some P power factors. Okay. Therefore, substituting that and cancelling this minus 4 by P, taking care of, and this is somewhere I made a mistake. Why this is? Suddenly I put that plus. Yeah, yeah. When it goes to the other side, WPP, this will be plus. Okay, that is plus, plus. Okay, this K by 2 minus 3 by this I forgot. So this is plus, plus. Therefore, this cancels out. This implies F bar UP square is exactly the W operator. Minus, if I do the P for K minus 1, F bar small. So whatever the P factor is cancelled out, then this is. So what we showed is that this implies that is, if F is in the new form space, F bar UP square is minus P power K minus 1 F bar WP. So since WP has two eigenvalues plus minus 1, therefore F is an eigen function under UP square. So when I take the, when I again further decompose the eigen classes into eigen forms with the WP, I can get an eigen function for the UP square also. Therefore, this completes the proof that F in the space SK plus F plus mu for n has a basis of eigen forms with respect to all HK operators TP square, UP square, and also the WP. So next is that, so that this implies SK plus half plus mu for n has a basis of eigen forms with respect to all TP square P not dividing n and UP square P dividing n and also with respect to WP. Okay, so next one is the computation of the dimension. So in the case of the plus space, so to get the isomorphism between the spaces SK plus half plus 4n and S2kn 4n computes spaces of HK operators acting on these spaces and shows that they are all equal. So as a consequence, the isomorphism is obtained as a consequence. It's a very tight, lengthy calculation that I told you that the Crelli paper, most of the computation goes to only the computation of the traces of HK operators, the most of them are. The remaining is only the operators, using these operators, and then you're completing the theory. So therefore, another thing is that, so we already saw in the case of level 1, he proved the mapping property using the Niwas isomorphism as well as the Shimura map sending level 4n to 2n. That's what, in a similar way, he proves the mapping property also, because now he has an isomorphism between plus mu 4n to level n. Now he makes use of Shimura's map, which is sending level 4n to level 2n, and then shows that same kind of technique. It shows that this Shimura Konon map maps exactly level is plus 4n to 2n. So I just mentioned this in words. Using this isomorphism, the technique is same, and using the T Shimura map. So for every T square free, there is a corresponding fundamental discriminant. Therefore, you have to take the T corresponding to what the fundamental discriminant you choose. Okay, so when you take T, the D fundamental discriminant, there will be a square free T attached to that. I consider the T Shimura map. So using this, and then the T Shimura map on SK plus half 4n apply this to 4n because I can this is contained in sk plus half level 4n. Therefore, I can apply Shibora map on this also, and whose image is in S2KM? Okay, whose image is in S2K2M? Because I am applying the Shibora map and employing similar techniques. Similar techniques means that he just go back and then I think it will take time. So using this and using similar techniques. Applied in the case n equal to 1, the mapping property is true. So that is SDK plus X SK plus half plus 4N to S2K. Yeah. Okay. So next one is that. So we have this theory of new forms, and then we have the mapping which is ending to level 4n to level n, and then one has a nice basis, a subspace having a nice basis of AK eigen forms called the new forms. So in order to get the isomorphism, and as we already saw that the mappings are non-trivial only when the dth coefficient is non-zero, which is again you have to remember that. So therefore, when you consider the Shimura map, Shimura Kohnen map, one needs to take the discriminant or fundamental discriminant or square free for which the non-zero coefficient is non-zero. Therefore, we need to show that given a new form, there is always a fundamental discriminant for which the dth coefficient is non-zero. So that he proves that we will see how this lemma is proved. So if f belongs to sk plus half plus mu 4n, then there is a fundamental discriminant d with minus 1 over k d positive such that af of mod d is non-zero. Okay, to prove this one, he proves another interesting lemma, which is, so if f belongs to the space sk plus of 4n, not necessarily plus plus n, and assume that the nth coefficient is 0, whenever n is 2 modulo 4, then f must be in the plus space. So you take any modular form in this full space, the level 4n, and assume that the nth coefficient is 0, whenever n is a 2 mod 4 number, then this is f should be in the plus space. Okay, the proof of the lemma sketch, I think we will see. So now what is first observe that n congruent to 2 mod 4 implies AFN is 0. This is equivalent to, then he replaces this condition by the condition on some kind of operator on this. So f bar 4104, 1 plus f bar 4 minus 104, 1. You take these two operators on the left hand side. This is nothing but 2 power minus k plus half f bar u4 bar 4001 2 power minus half. So, okay. Now, this is exactly when you assume that the AFN is 0 whenever n is 2 mod 4, then you can get this equivalent to this showing this one equal. Now, apply the trace. This 4104 takes forms of level 4n to level 16n. So applying the trace operator, from gamma 0 16n to gamma 0 4n on both the sides, and use this property that f bar psi plus psi dash, I did, let me see, I will try to do whether I can get this psi plus psi dash. Where did I write? Yeah, so I put some star, double star. This is, yeah, this one it will come. except psi plus psi star. Yeah, this is the one. F plus psi plus psi dash is retains only the 0 or 1 mod 4 coefficient and changes the sign of the 2 or 3 mod 4 coefficient. There is another identity which I put double star. Let me see, where is the double star? I am forgetting where is double star. If it is not there, you will be in trouble. Okay. I hope. Let me see where I did the double star. Double star is that the Q is nothing but a psi bar trace. Okay, the operator Q is nothing but psi bar trace. Okay, again in this date. Okay. So, and use the fact, use F bar psi plus psi dash, roughly speaking, is up to some constant summation 0 or 1 mod 4 minus summation 2 or 3 mod 4. This is one identity. And F bar Q is psi bar trace. Yeah, try psi bar trace. Okay, this one, these two facts, if I use it and also assume that and Q is Hermitian, all these things one has to use, one obtains all these things. We have epsilon. So when the epsilon should not be there, in this case I am taking the character, trivial character, so epsilon will not be there. So otherwise I have to put epsilon minus 1 power k plus 1 by 2 square root of 2 f bar q is 2 power minus k plus half f bar u4 bar 4 0 0 1 2 power minus half bar trace. Okay. So f bar q is exactly the psi bar trace. So therefore the right hand side becomes, so the RHS equal to 1 by 2 of 4 times f plus minus 1 power k plus 1 by 2 square root of 2 f bar q. One can show this. Okay. So after some simplification, I can show that the right hand side is some constant time f times some constant time f bar the q operator. Therefore, putting this one and taking all the q together, so finally this implies finally f bar q after simplification, we have minus 1 power k plus 1 by 2, 2 root 2 f. And this is exactly this alpha. So there is an epsilon factor there, and in this case it will not be there. Otherwise, when you start with character, that epsilon will be there. So this is exactly alpha f. So that means f belongs to the alpha eigenspace. This implies f belongs to the plus space. That's what he proves. He starts with the n congruent 2 mod 4 af and 0. Then he observes this kind of identity, matrix identity in terms of the u4, and then uses the previously computed fact that psi and psi adjoint gives you the Fourier coefficient in this fashion, and assume that and the fact that this Q operator, he defined Hermitian operator, is nothing but psi bar trace up to some factorizing. So put together everything, the whole this identity becomes shows that F is an eigenfunction under Q with eigenvalue alpha. So therefore, this lemma gives you the fact that whenever n is 2 mod 4 coefficient vanishing, implies that f should be in the plus case. This is the main thing. Next, how he proves the existence of a fundamental discriminant. So let f be a new form. Non-zero, k eigenform. K eigenform. Okay, I'll write. Claim is that there is a fundamental discriminant such that f mod d is non-zero. Suppose not, that is, for all fundamental discriminants d with minus 1 power k d, af of mod d is 0. So that's what I am assuming. Then the function has the property, which function? Then f bar u4 has the property that its nth Fourier coefficient 0 whenever n is 2 modulo 4. Okay, So by just, you see, assuming that all the fundamental experiment, if I take AF mod D that is zero, then it will imply that F bar U4, if I apply the nth coefficient when it's 2 mod 4, all of them vanish. Okay. Therefore, again, use the previous lemma. This implies F bar U4 belongs to the plus space, which is a contradiction. Okay. If F is in the plus space, U4 does not preserve the plus space structure. Therefore, this is a contradiction. So this is a contradiction. Therefore, there should exist one fundamental experiment for which the dth coefficient is non-zero. Okay, and this completes the paper of the Krelia's paper. I think main issues are there: finding, defining the new form space, and then finding a basis of AK Eigen forms, showing the new form space has the basis of AK Eigen forms, and finally the spaces are isomorphic. Okay, this new form to new form, and as well as when you take the plus Eigen space intersect with the new form, there is also an isomorphism, because all of them will follow from the dimension formula that he proves. Okay, so a little before I go to the other one, a little bit about this paper extension. I'll not go much details into the extension of this work and in our work. This is a long back with Monicum and Vasudevan. This is 1990. Came. Okay, we generalized this one to the full space. So we generalize the new form theory to the case this k plus half 4n with the same condition in R square. Not necessarily in the plus space. Okay. So in that paper we showed that U4 W4 is minus 1 power k plus 1 by 2 into epsilon 2 power k minus 3 by 2 q. Therefore, one can also characterize in terms of the U4 W4. Whatever the characterization in terms of q is exactly the characterization of U4 W4. And there is a slight change of the W4 operator which we consider, and the W4 operator considered by Conan. So W4, this W4 is equal to, so there is a small difference up to a plus minus one factor. Between our W4 and W4 considered by Conan. That factor is exactly the 2 by 2 k plus 1. So the difference is the plus minus one depending on. So for certain values of k, it is the same, but for certain values of k, it takes minus. Okay. What we showed is that you take this sk plus half 4n is sk plus half in a similar cone way. One can show that this is orthogonal direction sk plus half u 4n by d bar 4d. D bar u r square, where r d dividing n d strictly less than n, and then this is orthogonal complement. So s k plus half mu 4 n has a basis of k Eigen forms, and with respect to all p p square p not dividing 2 n and u p square p dividing 2 n. So there is only the p equal to 2 is the difference there, and and w p is the same as p dividing capital N, and in w2 we take as w4. So for p equal to 2, the w4 operator is the Atkin-Lehendran involution. So there is a linear combination also. This sk plus half 4n is isomorphic to s2k 2n. This is proved by Niva. Therefore, one can find here whatever the results are told for plus space, the same is true for the full space also. So one can find a linear combination of Shimura maps, which is an isomorphism between these two spaces. Okay. So for also for P dividing N, we also have SK plus half plus minus P, not in the plus space but in the full space, because WP is the same operator for the full space as well as the plus space. I can decompose the plus space into plus minus eigenspace. I can also decompose the whole space into the plus minus. So this is the whole space plus minus. That also has the same property that F, such that AFN is F bar WP is plus minus F, and the characterization is in terms of the same Fourier coefficient condition for minus 1 power k n by t is minus plus 1. Okay. And why I mentioned this one, because there is another interesting consequence of similar characterization when p equal to 2 in the full space. So when p dividing n, so for especially for p equal to 2, in my work with Savoli and Monicum, it came up with some other context, so we had to prove this one. So this 2010, I think. So what we showed is that the same I can just decompose with respect to the W4, which is set of all F, such that F bar W4 is plus minus F. That is characterized by AFN is 0 for minus 1 power kn by 2 is minus plus. So I told you the factor is, this factor is floating around, so they have to, instead of minus plus 1, it will be 2 by 2k plus 1. So depending on this one, either it is a plus 1 or minus 1. So therefore, we can have a similar characterization in terms of the Fourier coefficient for the plus minus eigenspace of W4. Okay, so so one can also take the new form, intersect with the new form. So this is true for, this is true for SK plus half plus minus 2, not for the whole, for the new form space, which is nothing but SK plus half plus minus 2 4n intersection with SK plus half new form. In intersecting with the full new form space, then we have this characterization. Okay, so not this plus minus is the original definition. Okay, so what we showed is that as a consequence, so as a consequence, the following was proved. I will not go into the much application of that, but this is an interesting application of a Shimura map on the theta power. Okay, so take minus 1 power kt positive, t square 3, t comma n is 1, and t by 2 is minus plus of the symbol 2 by 2k plus 1. Then this map st n, I can write Shimura map, maps. I can also talk about the modular form. So just when I put m, you can talk about this, this plus minus 2 4 n into m 2 k n. So instead of going, this Shimura map always takes the level 4 n to 2 n, but in this particular case, whenever t by 2 is minus plus of this symbol, then the Shimura map maps even takes down the level by another 2 factor. So in particular, if n equal to 1, t by 2 is minus of 2 by 2k plus 1, this, we have the classical theta series. I trace it to the power 2k plus 1, it is a weight k plus half form. If I apply st2, this belongs to m2k. Otherwise, if I apply the Shimura map on any weight k plus half form level 4, it goes to level 2. Okay, so where theta is 2 power n square, n is the theta. So this is a special property which I obtained as the classification of the W4 operator. Okay, next we will go to the next section. I think this will be continued in the afternoon class also.
Sir?
Yes.
Yeah, I am Karam Dev.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So just I was wondering how big this space is, just what you defined, plus minus 2.
How big means what? It
the dimension or something is calculated? Or?
I think I calculated, I forget. Okay, it is in terms of the level 1 form, one can do that in case of n equal to 1.
Uh-huh.
You computed the dimension, sir. I'll tell you tomorrow. I have to go through the paper again. Okay.
Okay. Okay. No problem, sir.
The computation is done.
Since it seems that it is completely disjoint to whatever plus, not completely disjoint, but it doesn't contain any of the whatever new form space and plus space.
Yeah, that's what. No.
So it is something separate subspace.
You're talking about this particular plus minus 2, 4.
Yes.
Why it should not contain? It will contain new form class, definitely.
You but took
because Shivar, the whole property is that the Shivara map annihilates this kind of new form class. That's what this part says.
Uh-huh.
So AFN is zero. When I apply this, the whole point is that it contains new form also in the decomposition.
Oh, since
because
you
of, intersect because of this property, because I'm taking T in this property, therefore the nth coefficient is zero whenever it is a new form.
Mm-hmm.
Therefore, the Shivara map is zero for those particular one. Therefore, it comes to only the old class. In the old class, again, you do the computation, it comes to level 1 only, finally. Ultimately, it will come to level 1.
But while defining new form space in plus minus 2, you are taking intersection with this new 4 area.
Yeah. Not in the plus. See, this plus minus is not the Conan plus space. I think there is
a difference.
That's what I did in the last class, the lectures. I think what I did, I put a K symbol for the plus minus P. Because where you do the plus minus, because WP eigenspace I can consider in the plus space as well as the whole space.
Yes.
To avoid the confusion, in my slide, I think one of the things I wrote plus minus comma P, if I'm right, I can show you that. I put a K there. I told that I didn't think that I will do that, but later on it was not as useful. Because I will tell you where I put. See, I can write it instead of going back. In fact, I think one should consider this plus minus in two different ways. One is that SK plus half plus minus comma P 4n, I put a K there. That means this plus minus P is in the Conan plus space.
Uh-huh.
And the other one is that plus minus P 4n is not in the Conan plus space, in the full space.
Okay.
Then when P equal to 2, this Conan space doesn't make any sense because the W4 will not preserve because W4 is exactly U4. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Therefore,
mm-hmm.
W4 doesn't make in this sense. So when you talk about P equal to 2, it is only in this space, not in the plus.
Okay.
But so many plus minus is appearing, so the confusion will be there. So.
Okay. And this one is a special for P equal to 2, as you were saying.
Exactly. Yeah, special to P equal to
2. Oh, yeah. Okay. Thanks, sir.
No, for P is odd prime, the operator is same, only the space is different. I can decompose the whole space as well as the plus space because it preserves both the spaces.
Uh-huh.
The small WPP odd, I think it preserves the Conan plus space as well as it preserves the full space. Therefore, I can consider this operator restricted to the plus space and then decompose into plus and minus.
Uh-huh.
And also, I consider the WP in the full space and also it has two eigenvalues plus minus. Therefore, I can consider the plus into full and plus minus into full.
Mm-hmm.
So, maybe the plus, there is also, I think I better not to go into because there one can do that. There are some other calculations which involves that. This plus space and some kind of duplication will be an eigenfunction of W4.
Okay, sir.
Okay, so
thanks.
In fact, at the plus space and U4, if you take a suitable linear combination,
mm-hmm.
that will be an eigenfunction of W4.
Mm-hmm.
So,
mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay,
so,
sir.
So far, I think a little bit extra what we did, I mentioned because of this particular special property, I mentioned this one. Now we move on to the Shintani map. Shintani correspondence. And as what's just there. Another important thing in this half integral bit case is the work of again Conan. So, all this generalized idea of Zagier. So, Zagier, who did it for the case of the Doyle-Nagonoma lifting. So he uses similar method applied in this particular setup. He just put it in this setup and then he obtained a correspondence adjoint to the Shimura map. and then as a consequence, using his uniform theory, he obtains an explicit version of the Walsh-Porter's theorem. Okay, so summary I'll mention after the work of before this Shintani correspondence is not before 85, this is before 85 it came. After the work of Shimura, Shintani, 1978, gave a correspondence in the reverse direction. So his method is called the theta kernel. So he uses, so that means S2k n sk plus half 4n. So take any cusp form of level n with 2k. Shintani constructed for each form, he constructed the modular form of k plus half level 4n. Okay, so the question is that. So immediately after that, there is a paper of Walsh-Porter that is again using representation theory methods. There is a very long paper, Walsh-Porter, I think it is in 1980-81. What he observed is that using representation theory methods, observation is that if F belonging to sk plus half 4n and capital F belong to s2k 2n. I'm not saying that Conan plays up, this is more generally Shimura map is level 4n to 2n or Heike Eigen forms.
Sir, in the previous line as well, it is 2n to 4n?
Where? Previous line.
This is after Shintani correspondence.
Okay. No, it is n to 4n, that's what I'm saying. So there is not Shintani didn't look for this. His mapping is n to 4n. Because oh. Level n, it is half integral weight is level 4n. So okay. The refinement of this Shintani correspondence by the method of Zagier and Conan gives you the proper correspondence from 2n to 4n or n to plus 4n. So one can construct in your whatever way you want to do, one can construct this method. This is really very good construction. One can fix two spaces where we have a Shimura correspondence, and then there is a natural way of extending this Shintani correspondence from the reverse direction. Okay. In his original work, it was done from n to 4n only.
Okay, n to 4n without consideration of plus space.
There is no plus space at that time. Because in 78, okay. The concept was not there. So, because in the Shimura map, Shimura's work tells you that the level of the half integral limit is 4n. Therefore, we start with the any n. Naturally, you think of level 4n only.
So, okay.
That reason, I think he might have done it.
And anyway, he's not saying it is bijective or something.
So nothing like that. I think this one was. I have not seen that. This is again using theta kernel. I have not seen the paper, but people refer to only the Shintani's correspondence. There may be some paper which I have to see.
Okay.
But this, though it is given Shintani correspondence, this Shintani correspondence is redefined in the context of the adjoint map is done by Zagier and Conan. That's what you should see.
Okay.
This is not exactly the construction of Shintani which we do. Okay? See, the correspondence is the reverse direction. Any reverse direction was first introduced by Shintani. Therefore, they call this as a Shintani correspondence. And more or less, they are similar. Okay, if you look at if you go deep into that one, the main concept will be the same. But a little bit modification is done so that you take your function in your own space. Okay, that's not in generally random n to 4n. I cannot randomly do that.
Maybe original Shintani image was not landing exactly in plus.
Not necessarily what I say, but the main concept may be the same. For example, this is theta kernel. Again, when we define the kernel function, this kind of cyclic integral also will involve. Okay, when you do this kind of Shintani lifting, but they are intrinsically involved. Okay, therefore I do not know the details. Therefore I cannot tell more on that. Okay.
But both method involve kernel function.
Kernels, exactly. That's what I mean. Without using the kernel function, you cannot do that. That's what he uses, the theta kernel, for getting this map.
Thanks.
So what the Walsh-Porter's result is that if I take F in the half integral weight and the capital F corresponding form in the integral weight or Heike Eigen forms which correspond via the Shimura map, then I got a f of n square of the nth Fourier. N, I think we will discuss. It is not. Sometimes we have to put the modulus, because when you always discuss the minus 1 over k d positive mod d, those things are coming. So when it precisely comes, we will mention what is either modulus n or should be there. Mod a f n square is proportional to the corresponding the L function of this corresponding modular form twisted by the character chi d. Chi d is, so the d will depend on related to this n. So given any n, the square free n, there is a fundamental discriminant associated to that. I take the character associated to this fundamental discriminant, twist this L function by this character, and compute the value at the center s equal to k, because of the level weight 2k is weight. So what he showed is that the square of the nth Fourier coefficient, if F and capital F correspond via Shimura and they are Hickey-Eigen form, essentially the square of this coefficient should correspond to or equal proportional to this L function. Okay, so this is very famous result. So how to find the exact constant of proportionality? That is another question. So they mentioned 1985 in this paper, Conan not only constructs Shintani correspondence, he also uses his theory of new forms, and then as a consequence obtains an explicit version of this particular proportionality. So that is, these are the main ingredients in the paper. We will see that. Okay, so actually the prior to that, n equal to 1 case was done by Conan and Zagier in 1981 paper. So note that this is, you can say that this is n equal to 1 is Conan Zagier 1981 paper, invention in paper. Okay, so this is what done for gamma 04 only. So then he extended this to gamma 04 and n odd, and then in particular n square free, when I take it, one can take the uniform theory and then I can apply. So okay, now we are coming to, what is, how much time I have? Another half an hour. Probably I can go up to the construction of the kernel function. Maybe in the second lecture I'll see how this is done. Okay, so we fix n odd, the space is sk plus half plus 4n Conan's plus space. So the idea is to construct a kernel function for these liptics. This means Shimura and Shintani. So this kernel function, this function is a function of two variable. You take z and tau both in the upper half plane, and with respect to z, it is a modular form. You fix a tau and then vary the z, it will be a modular form of weight 2k, level n, and with respect to tau, that means fixing z, it is a modular form. Of weight k plus 1 by 2 level or on. So the level, sometimes people don't write, because when Conan calls his level as capital N only, because all his plus space level N forms correspond to the level N integral weight form. Therefore, he writes this as capital N only. So, but when you look at, it should be the group, it should be gamma 04N, but some subspace you are constructing. Therefore, when you say level, there is an ambiguity. You have to be careful that in which context it is level is used. Okay, but in the case of integral weight, level is a fixed one. There is no variation. You cannot change the definition of level in the case of integral weight. But in the half integral weight case, one can call this as a level n, because it is corresponding to level n in the integral weight. In the full space, either you can call it as level 2n or level 4n, because that is, group is anyway 4n. Okay, so to avoid this kind of ambiguity, I am writing on 4 comma 04. Okay, so the function with respect to z will involve some kind of function which is a modular form of integral weight, that is used using the that is again called the kernel function for the cyclic integral. So there is again one kernel function, the class of form, and with respect to tau, we make use of another important class of response which I missed to tell, that is pancreases. When you talk about modular forms, the natural examples come from Isenson series, and then next one is the pancreas series, then only other things come out. Okay, so there is another important class of forms which are cusp forms. They are called pancreas series. So we make use of pancreas series of Papandrakil rate to construct the function with respect to tau, and we use the kernel function for cyclic integral to construct forms of integral weight with respect to that. So you use these two functions, you define a function, put the other variable as expansion, and define the function and show that this indeed is equal to the function defined with respect to the other one. So that is the whole idea of this. Okay, first we'll fix k greater than, so k equal to 1 also he does it. I'm not going into the details. For simplicity, we take n greater than or equal to 1, take d dash integers such that d dash is positive and d comma d dash, they are all 0 or 1 mod. All discriminants, not necessarily fundamental, but we take d to be fundamental discriminant, d dash be any 0 or 1 mod. So define the function. The parameters are kn, z, d, d prime. So it is a function of z, it is a half integral weight form, which is defined as, to take out all the quadratic forms, a, b, c, b square, a square, ax square plus bx plus c, and then this discriminant is your d, d dash, and then assume that this a is divisible by n. So the everything is involved in this one, and there is a genus character of this quadratic form u, wd, and then we have the quadratic form a square plus bz plus c power minus k, where z is in the upper half. So consider this particular series where the sum varies over over all quadratic forms. Q I can avoid, it's better to maybe write Q, that's okay. Q equal to A, B, C, which is A x square plus B x plus C, x y plus C y square, can do, whose discriminant is D, D dash and N divides it. Okay? And the W, omega d of abc is the genus character which takes the value d by r if r, if d represents, if q represents r and all abcd gcd is 1. So whenever the abc are relatively prime to the fundamental discriminant D and this Q quadratic form represents R, this character value is exactly D by R, otherwise it is 0. So that is the character defined. Now one can easily see that the series converges absolutely and uniformly and on compact sets, therefore it defines a holomorphic function. So the function is holomorphic on H. And also one can show that it is a modular form indeed, a modular form of V2K of level N. So this N equal to 1, this was studied by Zai here. Then N equal to 1 case. So that is in a correction with the Dai Nagano and Lifting. So that is first considered by him. Okay, so further, so this is a holomorphic. In fact, FKN is a B, B prime belongs to S2K of N. So I can also define this function for character also for simplicity. Even I don't think Conan does it for character. So one has to introduce a character in this in before this one. So they are all complicated one. One can do that. In general, one can construct these functions with the character also. But here this is the trivial character. So it is a modular form of V2K level N. So on one side, we are going to make use of this for this particular omega function. So use first we define the function and then we'll see that. So we use this one, define define the kernel function using FKL as follows. Okay, k is greater than or equal to 2. Integer, d is a fundamental discriminant. Minus 1, 4, k, d positive. And then for z, tau in the upper half plane. Define this capital omega depends on k, n, z, tau, and d. So there are two variables, z, tau, and then one parameter d related to that, which is equal to this index of gamma 0 n, I n is the index. There is some constant depending on k and d. And then you take the series m greater than or equal to 1. I need, because I am going to make use of this function, which is an integral weight modular form. But I want this function to be a half integral weight modular form also. That's what I told you in the beginning. So it is a two variable function. I make use of this fkn to define this. That means with respect to z, it is a modular form of integral weight. But with respect to tau, it should be a half integral weight case. Since I need this kernel function to be in plus space, I put the conditions here. Minus 1 power k m, 0 or 1 mod. Because I need only these coefficients. You take m power k minus half and summation t dividing n, the Mobius function mu of t, d by t, t power k minus 1. You consider this function f k, take the level n by t, and then duplicate it, t is there. I have d minus 1 power k. Yeah. You see, this function is defined when d, d prime is a 0 or 1 mod 4. So that makes sense here, because I am taking minus 1 power km in terms of d dash, and I am taking minus 1 power km is 0 or 1 mod 4. So after this, you put the exponential factor with respect to tau. So using these functions, so you look at this fk n by t of level n by t. Since I am duplicating by t z, therefore this, the whole function of fk n by t t z is a form of level n and weight 2k forms. Therefore, this omega, capital omega kn, this series represents a modular form of weight 2k and level n. But later on, we'll show that we'll also define this in terms of the half integral weight forms and show that these two representations are same. So I can represent this in terms of one function. I can also prove that the same thing has another expansion with respect to the other variable. I'll prove that the whole effect is that we have to show that these two things are one and the same. So in is index of gamma 0 n in SL2Z, and CKD is some k plus 1 by 2 mod d minus k plus half. So these constants will really irritate, because if you miss something, no, you will not get what you want. So unless you take care of all the constants together, you will not get the precise result. So otherwise, something will be floating around.
Yes.
Yes. Then, if omega k n, a modular form of it. So when k equal to 1, you have to do more assumptions. Okay. So now we need to express this in terms of the half integral weight. Next, we express this function omega in terms of half integral weight forms. So that is called the Poincaré series we'll introduce. So far I have not told what the Poincaré series. So there are cusp forms. Which are characterized by as follows. Okay, so for each m greater than or equal to 1, the function pk n m of tau the Poincaré series m. Poincaré series of weight 2k level n is characterized by the property that when I take the inner product with any function f, which will give you up to some constant, the mth Fourier coefficient. The constant is gamma of k minus 1 by 4 pi m power. I think here it should be 2k minus 1. The 8 minus 1 will be the correct one, where f belongs to s2km. Okay? So that means the Poincare series all generate the space of such forms, because when I take the orthogonal complement of all the span of pknm, you get all zero, because with the Fourier expansion will be zero for the complement. Therefore, this Poincare series generate the space of such forms of weight k and level n. So when I run over all m, okay, so that is special property. One can find the Fourier expansion and other properties. In the case of half integral weight, the same is true. So pkm m belongs to s2k of n for all m greater than equal to 1. So that is another fact. So in the case of half integral weight, so similarly for m greater than equal to 1, one has the mth Poincare series. I put the script p for the level n m. I put this what they write tau is there. I don't know the tau is there. I think we'll just see later. For integral weight, I think we are making use of is there, because this one for a tau is half integral, so I can put this is there. Here I can put the tau characterized by f comma k plus r n m. Yes, there will be one index coming to the picture because of the Petersen scalar product has this factor. Therefore, this will come up in this case. In the case of half integral weight, it won't come. So this is script p k plus half n m is in s k plus half 4 n space, okay, for all m greater than or equal to 1. Now what quantum does it? This is usual Poincare series in the space. You project it to the plus case. So let ordinary p, I put the plus, is p k plus half n m bar projection belonging to s k plus half plus 4. So what he does, he computes only the Poincare series and then he obtains his projection map and applies the projection map on capital script p and finally gets the Poincare series in the space of half integral weight in the plus space. So then we will consider the Fourier expansion when it prove this one. The theorem is, what you have to find the function omega k n z tau b defined above in terms of this integral weight forms. This is what I define. This is also given by the forms. Who has the following Fourier development? With respect to z, so this is defined as a Fourier expansion in terms of tau. The theorem says that the same function has a different expansion. Now it is with respect to z. That's what it says. Okay, so this is again in terms of omega k n z tau d equal to index c k d inverse. They are all the same. There is some extra constant k by 2, 3 into 2 pi power k by factorial k minus 1 to summation n equal to 1 to infinity n power k minus 1 into summation d dividing n d comma capital N is 1 is d by d n by d power k. The Poincare series pk plus half n square by d square mod d plus of tau e power 2 pi I n is. So this is the main theorem. So we started with the function f integral weight, and then constructed this omega function, which is a modular form of weight 2k. So this belongs to s2kn. Okay, then the next one is that we show that this function can be expressed in terms of Fourier expansion with respect to z involving the Poincare series. So in particular, for a fixed z in H, this omega km z tau d belongs to sk plus half plus 4i. Okay, so therefore we have constructed a kernel function, and then it remains to show that it is indeed the function which is modular form of integral weight in one sense and modular form of half integral weight in the other variable. So the theorem is proved, or how it is proved is, I have the two definitions for the omega function. I compute the Fourier expansion of this function fk. Independently I can compute, you plug in the Fourier coefficient here, it will be a expansion in terms of z. Therefore this whole function is having a Fourier expansion, and then the Fourier expansion with respect to tau and z. Okay, now consider the Fourier expansion of the Poincare series, you plug in the Fourier coefficient with respect to tau. So I have also the omega function expressed as a different Fourier coefficient. I have this expansion with respect to z and tau. Both are Fourier expansions with respect to z and tau on both the sides, but both of them are having two different expressions. So to observe that the both the expressions coming on the left and right, they are the same. Okay, so fix any z coefficient and tau coefficient together, and then show that the Fourier coefficients are the same. So that is everything comes naturally, and then finally one can show that they are indeed equal. Therefore these functions represent with respect to one variable integral weight form, with respect to the other variable it is a half integral weight form. One can use this to define the Shimura and Shintani maps. Okay, so how much time left? 45. So let me see whether I can state the theorem and prove, and or I define these maps. I think I'll define the map, and then we'll next class I think we'll do that. Okay, so how okay, what is the Shimura map? And the Shimura map is just again defined. So d is fundamental discriminant minus 1 power k d positive, and then have a g of tau is c of n, so 2 pi a n tau n greater than or equal to 1 in the plus space. Don't bother either I put the condition, because it's the plus space, naturally that condition will be there. So we have g bar s d s k d n plus weight level n is summation n greater than or equal to 1, summation d dividing n, d from capital N is 1, d by d. So whenever character is there is a chi of d will come. So I think in the some time back I wrote with character, here I am considering the trivial character, therefore that will not come. C of n square by d square mod d e power 2 pi I n tau n is that. This is the tau, so you can put the variable. Okay, that's not a problem, tau or z is not a problem. Okay, so this is a Shimura map, this belongs to s2k n, which is already proved. Now we define the Shintani map. So define as follows. Again I fix the d here, so let for before defining this Shintani, we'll just define some integral, and then using this integral we'll define dm as above. D is a fundamental discriminant, m is this discriminant. So let r k n, for each f I define this one, d is minus 1 4 km. So when you define this f, these two parameters we used, which is equal to summation over all quadratic form modulo gamma 0 n, where the discriminant is mod d m, and then q of 1 0 is the a element, which is 0 modulo m. So I have the omega d of q. This is exactly the character which I mentioned in the definition of small f, and the integral over cq of this function f is a d q comma k of z. We will explain what is cq, where q abc runs over a set of gamma 0 n inequivalent integral binary quadratic forms of discriminant with n divides a, that a is exactly q of 1 0, and cq is nothing but cq is the image of image in the fundamental domain of the semicircle a is f square plus b real part of z plus c equal to 0. The orientation is given in terms of orientation from left to right. If a is positive, from right to left, if a is less than 0, and from minus c by b to I infinity, if a equal to 0. There are three cases. A 0 means it is a line from minus c by b to I infinity. If a positive, from left to right you do that, otherwise from right to left. So that is the integral. And then this, the differential dqk is dqk of z is nothing but a z square plus b z plus c power minus k, or k minus 1 d z. Okay, that is what. So to avoid this one, then he shortens the a z plus to b z plus c power k minus 1 into d z. So then with this definition of this cyclic integral corresponding to the function in S2K2N, which was defined, this is for every f, okay? For every f, I can define this. Now, using this, he defines the Shimmer-Shintani map. So, the Shintani lift. Of f belonging to S2KN is defined by f bar s k d n. This is plus, I put a star because we are going to show that this is adjoint to the Shimura map. Therefore, I can of z, this is summation m greater than or equal to 1. Sorry, this should be tau. Tau is minus 1 power km, 0 over 1 mod 4, summation t dividing n, u of t, d by t, t power k minus 1, this is cyclic integral rk, what did I write, rk, n, instead of n, I put nt of f, d, minus 1 4 k m t square t power 2 pi I m tau. So whatever we define, there are mappings only. We have not yet proved the map. In fact, there was already proved that this takes half integrate forms to the integral rate of level L. Only things remaining is that you have to show that this mapping sends forms of integral rate to forms of half integrate rate in the plus space. Okay, that is a theorem. So this is theorem. The mappings S K D N plus and sk dn plus star defined by defined as above map sk plus half plus 4n to s2kn and vice versa respectively. So instead of vice versa, I think there should not be confusion. So and s2kn to sk plus half plus 4n respectively. Better to be precise. So they are adjoint. With respect to the vectors of scalar product, and one has, so these maps can be given in terms of the vectors of scalar product of the functions with respect to the kernel functions. One has in the product of g comma omega of k n minus z bar. So now I am fixing that z variable as minus z bar because I am the second component, and I take the inner product gives you the g bar s k d n plus, okay, and then f comma omega k n minus tau bar d is f bar s k d n plus star. So if I take the inner product of any function g in the half integral weight case, take with this omega k n as a function of tau variable, then I get the Shimura map of g, and I take the inner product of f with this with respect to the z variable, then I get the Shintani map of f. So this belongs to half integral weight, this belongs to integral weight. So I think I'll stop now because too much of going on. I'll prove these things, and then as a consequence of this one, we'll next one is the Washbridge's result. Preliminary, that those things I will do in the next class. So any questions you can ask, but we will try to give explanations of how this is proved in the next, I think today's next class. I will try to finish it with giving some kind of indications how this kind of results are proved.